Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tiffany Murphy. A solution to the vanishing vaccine supply in Southeast Texas is imminent tonight. Operation Warp Speed led to the rapid creation of several vaccines to protect us against COVID-19. But distribution of the shots is a lot slower. KFDM's Angel San Juan joins us tonight in the studio to tell us what's being done locally to hurry up that process. Angel.
Initially, when the vaccines were made available, there was concern people would not want to receive them, worried about their risk. Turns out on the local front here in Southeast Texas, lots of you want to get the shot, especially many senior citizens. But the question is, where? This is Lester Valiant's life, confined to his bed, not able to leave this bedroom of his home in the north end of Beaumont. His phone and television are his lifelines.
I live with just my TV. That's what I have to have. When that TV goes out, I go crazy.
Lately, though, Lester is spending more time on his phone than watching TV. He's calling everywhere for a COVID-19 vaccine. The 69-year-old's health history makes him vulnerable to the virus.
I heard it on TV about the vaccine, and a lot of people said, well, I'm not taking this. But I said, I'm going to take it because I want it to be able to help me. I don't want to get the COVID.
But he's had no luck.
I called and they said we don't even have any right now. That's what I was told the other day.
Adding to his anxiety is the lack of access for folks like him who are homebound.
I told him that I need to get it over here because I can't drive and I can't hardly walk. And they don't know how they're going to help me get the vaccine.
But distribution can't happen without having the vaccine in hand to begin with. Dr. Eze Eda is the head of the Jefferson County Public Health Department. He's still waiting for the county's allotment, which it requested on December 28th.
I'm anxious and frustrated. I wanted the vaccine to come in so we can start putting it in people's arms because the disease is multiplying every day.
Dr. Eda is right. Jefferson County has the 22nd highest number of COVID cases of all 254 Texas counties.
I think it's time we yell.
Commissioner Senegal's precinct includes the city of Port Arthur, and he's disappointed at the low number of vaccines that the city's public health department received.
We're one of the major counties in Southeast Texas outside of Harris County, and I just think, you know, we should be ahead of the game. I'm just, you know, I try and be real patient, but my patience is very short right now.
And across the river in Orange County, County Judge John Gauthier shares similar concerns.
Everybody wants this vaccine. I mean, there's a lot of people that want it. And we're waiting on that supply to come. And then so the federal government controls the supply, and then they send it to the state. And then the state controls that supply out to the 254 counties.
That distribution, though, has obviously hit a snag, raising questions about whether the government had a proper plan.
The government should have been doing this, but it hasn't done this.
It's my opinion that it would have been very appropriate for government to have developed a plan if it could have been done from the state and laid out as a suggestion to every county or every area of the state of Texas, then we might have been able to kick it off much more quickly. It also should have come from federal government. To be perfectly honest with you. So I can't just say that the state didn't do its job. Everybody's doing something and everybody's trying to do something. This is new. We don't do this very often. And so making mistakes or falling short, don't blame someone for it. Let's get it done. We got a real problem. People are getting sick.
Nick Lamson is a former Southeast Texas congressman who now serves as co-chief operating officer at Riceland Healthcare. In recent weeks, after vaccinating its frontline healthcare staff, Riceland has used any extra doses on first responders, like Jefferson County deputies.
Our CEO made the determination that he would fight early for as much vaccine as he could get. We have vaccinated over 1,000 people.
In our 8-county region, we have a population of nearly 500,000 people, but statistics show fewer than 4,000 have been vaccinated. Riceland is hoping to ramp up those numbers, proposing a plan to the 8 counties.
In our opinion, the solution is for us to collectively work together with these various counties in our region and see if we can find one or more necessarily, not possibly, locations where we can do drive-by inoculations Have people come, don't even get out of their cars. We'll have multiple lines, and we would like to be doing at least 1,000 vaccinations a day.
Strength in numbers, counties combining their efforts to convince the state to provide them with the vaccines their communities so desperately need.
As a whole, we're a lot bigger, and you know, maybe we can get some of that stuff coming, and we can get established as a hub as well, and to be able to use that availability to vaccines to get us more of them.
Lamson says this is not just a Riceland project, it's a cooperative effort of counties coming together for a common good.
Because we're going to need things as mundane as traffic control. We're going to need people guiding cars through paths, and we're going to need not just a nurse to give a shot, but someone to do the paperwork leading up to that shot, someone to do the paperwork following the shot, someone to monitor the person to make sure that there is no adverse reaction.
Building a plan down to the smallest detail to address one of the largest threats we've faced in our lifetimes. Leaders confident we can make the area safe with plenty of vaccine. Lamson expects the state to approve our regional vaccination plan early next week, with the administering of shots ramping up by the end of next week. Stay tuned for further updates on this developing situation. Tiffany.